Welcome to the spoken tutorial on Introduction to Gmail. In this tutorial, we will learn to create a new Google account, log in to Gmail using the Google account, write an email, send an email, view an email, and log out of Gmail. We will also learn about some of the important mailboxes like inbox. For this tutorial, you will need a working internet connection and a web browser. For demonstration, I will be using Firefox web browser. Lately, Google has provided a single account for all Google products like Gmail, YouTube, Google Play, Google Docs or Drive, Google Calendar, and more. So, with the same login, you can operate any of these. Let's begin by creating a new Google account. Open your web browser and type http://gmail.com. It will take us to the page where we can see two options at the top right. Create an account and sign in. If this is the first time this page is accessed from your machine, it will look like this. If this page has already been accessed from your machine, then the page will look like this. So, you will see text boxes to enter your email username and password, and a big button that says sign in. Below this, you will see a link that says create an account. Let's click on the create an account link. We are now in the Google account creation page. We can see a form on the right wherein we have to fill our account and personal details. Let's enter our first and last names in the respective text boxes. I will give my name as Rebecca Raymond. Next, we have to choose our username. Username has to be unique and can be made up of alphabets or alphanumeric combinations. Let's give the username as Becky0808. If the username is already taken, we will see the following message. Someone already has that username, try another. Google will also suggest some usernames based on the first and last names we have given. We can give any username of our choice and check for availability. Now, I will give the username as ray.becky.0808. This goes through, which indicates this username is available. Now, we have to create a password for this account. The information box on the left tells us how long the password should be. Type a suitable password of your choice. Then, retype the password to confirm it. After this comes birthday. Select the month from the drop-down. Then, type the day and year in the respective text boxes. Now, select your gender. I am selecting female. The next field is the mobile phone. I will skip this for now. After this is a text box that asks for our current email address. If you have an alternate email address apart from the one you are creating now, type it here. If you don't, leave it as blank. Let's fill the remaining details now. The next segment, Prove You're Not a Robo, has two verification steps. Phone verification, puzzle verification. We can proceed with any one of these two options. I will go with the puzzle verification. Type the text or number shown in the image in the Type the Text text box. The country where you are located is displayed by default in the location drop-down. I am located in India, so India is shown in my location drop-down. Lastly, click on I agree to the Google Terms and Privacy Policy checkbox to check it. Once all the details are filled in the form, we have to click on Next Step button. Right now, we will not do so. Let us see what to do if we select phone verification. Click on the Skip this verification, phone verification may be required checkbox. Choose the location as India. Then click on I agree to the Google Terms and Privacy Policy checkbox. And lastly, click on Next Step. It will divert to the phone verification page. Select your country flag from the drop-down. I am selecting India. Enter your mobile number in the text box provided. Select Text Message SMS option. Usually, it will be selected by default. Then, click on Continue button. You will receive an SMS on your phone. It will now take you to the next part of verification. Type the verification code you received from Google via SMS in the text box provided. Click on Continue. We are now in the Create Your Public Google Plus profile page. Here, you can see your name. Below this, there is an option to add a photo. You can click on this to add a photo for your Google profile. There is also a button named Create Your Profile. For the time being, I am skipping these steps. Instead, I will click on No Thanks button to proceed to my email account. Now, we are in the Welcome page. And in my case, it says Welcome Rebecca. My new email address ray.becky.0808@gmail.com is also displayed. Now, click on Continue to Gmail button. It will start loading your mail account. Based on your internet speed, this may take some time. If our internet is slow, we can click on Load Basic HTML. It is available at the right side bottom. It will load Gmail without any graphical look. Some information boxes will pop up on the screen. Read them or explore further by clicking on the next button and then close them. This is the default or standard view of your Gmail account. The center display area is where we can see all our mails. Notice there are three tabs here. We will learn about them in detail in future tutorials. On the left side, we can see some labeled menu items. Inbox, Start, Sent Mail, Drafts, and more are some of the prominent mailboxes of Gmail. By default, Inbox is selected and its contents are shown in the display area. Notice that Inbox has number 3 in brackets. This indicates the number of new mails that you have received. When we create a new Google account, we get some mails from the Gmail team. You can read them for more information on how to use Gmail features. Now, let's learn how to write an email. Click on the Compose button on the left-hand side. A window with the name New Message opens up. It has 4 segments. 2 is the place where we type the email address of the person to whom we want to send the email. Here, I'll type the same email ID that we created just now, that is ray.becky.0808@gmail.com. It means that I am sending a mail to myself. Next segment is subject. Here we can type the brief subject line about the mail. Let's say, Welcome Mail. Next is the content area. Here we have to write our message that we want to send. Let's type Greetings to all from the Spoken Tutorial Project. In the last segment, there is a blue button that says Send. Click on it to send the email. Notice the number of mails in the inbox is now 4. To read a particular mail, simply click on it. Here is the mail I sent to myself. Let's have a look at it. Click on the Show Details arrow. Here are the email addresses of the sender and receiver. Here is the date and time when the email was sent. Here is the subject line of the email. And the content is here. Now, notice that the number of 100 emails in the inbox is 3. Now, let us learn how to sign out from Gmail. At the top right, you will see your email ID. If you had uploaded a photo during account creation, then you will see that here instead. Click on it. Here is the sign out button. Just click on it to sign out. You have successfully signed out of Gmail. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. We learned to create a new Google account, log into Gmail using the Google account, write an email, send an email, view an email, and log out of Gmail. The video at the given link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. We conduct workshops and give certificates to those who pass our online tests. For details, please write to us. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by NMEICT MHRD Government of India. More information on this mission is available at this link. This script has been contributed by Praveen, and this is Sri Lakshmi from IIT Bombay signing off. Thanks for watching.